We do research and development for virtual and augmented reality systems.
It means collaborative research, engineering, analysis, and testing in immersive virtual environments. So we use the Oculus Rift, which is a fairly well-known virtual reality headset. We've used the HTC Vive, which is a competitor. For augmented reality, we use the Microsoft HoloLens. Most of these guys use the Unity gaming engine. It's a piece of software that's used to develop the environments that we're immersing people in. And we use the standard engineering products like Creo for modeling.
As the technology advances, so some of the things that just in the consumer market are coming along would be like wireless VR headsets. So as those things start to come out, it'll be a lot easier for us to deploy things and come up with new concepts of operation for some of the technology. So I think that's kind of what's coming down the pipeline. Big consideration right now is on maintenance actions. So a lot of what we're looking at are ways to aid maintainers out in the field. So information that can be pulled up on demand within their field of view without them needing a computer nearby, without them needing their hands so that they can continue on a maintenance action and be able to look up something in a technical manual at the same time.
We're doing one thing that's kind of unique, I think, for the base. We're doing an actual human research project studying the effects of shipboard motion on simulator sickness. So we're going to be putting people in a Connex box, basically a big metal box on a motion platform, and seeing what the effects of different sea states are with people using VR.
A lot of the AR research, I think, is definitely going to be something that's more applicable in the next few years. So like the Innovation Challenge project, the Karma project, is working here in the Creative Lab, and a lot of what they're doing, I think, is something that in the next 5 years we'll actually be seeing at least bits and pieces of it out deployed in the fleet. We'll have maintainers using that equipment, which is really cool.